Hello everyone, it's Farkad here, and in this video I'm going to show you the damage that all the enemies can do to you in the forest. Now this only covers hard and hard survival. I'll put up something either in the description or on the video right now to show you the differences. Basically, all the starting enemies do about double damage on hard and hard survival, but as it gets later in the game, their damage increase isn't as much. Now there's a lot to cover here, so I'm going to get straight into it. Now the testing methodology I used Danny Parker's mod that reports back the damage that the player and enemies do. On the left side here, I have the console log that reports back all the damage that's going on. Up the top here is just information that you get when you're using console commands F2. Can't remove it. You can ignore that part. Over here is a picture of the enemy, just to give you a visual of who I'm talking about. And down here, I've put the information that I found. Save you having to look at the numbers there. And I did get some variations in the damages. This is most likely done on purpose, so to stop us from figuring out how much damage they do. They don't want us to know how the AI works. Just going to cover some things first. There's no rage or pissed off system, so blocking their attacks or setting them on fire doesn't change their damage, though they might become more hostile towards you. There was something I found called damage clamped. I don't know what it really did, though the more he hit me, the more damage he did, but it started off really weak, like around 21, and then slowly worked its way up. I'm not a game dev, so I can't really explain how this works, though it was very rare to happen. Also, killing females doesn't increase others' damage, though they are more likely to attack you. I'm going to start from lowest damage to highest damage. At first is a pale skinny. He only does 20 damage. Though some attacks did do 26, it was mainly the initial attack. Now, probably the most important thing about this video is that it doesn't matter if they do a big swing, a leap swing, or just a single attack. They all do the exact same damage. There are a couple of exceptions though, and that's with the next weakest damage, and that is the worm. Its damage is only 25. That includes its stomp and Jenga, where it falls on you. All the worm's attacks do barely any damage to the player. Its damage to structures, however, is completely different. It does a lot more to structures. So if you're fighting this thing one-on-one when you're not near your structures, it's probably quite easy to kill. All of its attacks cannot be blocked and all of them will knock you over. Next is a cowman. He actually has the exact same damage as the worm. All of his attacks will knock you over and they can't be blocked. So this includes the charge, the belly flop, the stomp, all that sort of stuff. Now you can't really get perma-stunned. While you're getting up the animation, you can't get knocked down again. Though if you've got about two or three around you, you probably could end up getting perma-stunned. But as soon as the animation is over, you get knocked down again. This is probably not a situation you want to be in. Armor blocks their damage. Armor works like health. So if you got 400 armor, that's like having 400 extra health. Next is a skinny female. She does 26 damage. I should remind you that all this damage is for hard and hard survival. I believe that skinnies do double damage on hard and hard survival. So on normal mode, it will probably only be doing 13 damage. So it's quite low. Though they are quite pesky and they can be annoying, especially if you're using a slow hitting weapon. Next is a skinny male. He did the same damage, which is 26. Though sometimes his first attack did 58, which is insane. That's a lot of damage because these guys spawn on day one. Though some attacks also did 35. It was quite common that their first attack did do it, and I repeated the test multiple times, as you can see. Even if they had a stick though, or a weapon, it didn't affect their damage. I did find in the past that normal cannibals, if they weren't using a club, they did plus 2 damage, so the tennis racket did more damage than their club. I don't know how it works, and it's probably not really relevant. A skinned mask variant, that did 32 damage. No variations found. Now, this is pretty much all the females. They all seem to do around 34 damage, and some attacks did 26. It was quite common that I died. That's why sometimes I'm using the modern axe, because it would report back the damage. If I use the rusty axe, because it blocks 100% damage, it didn't report back any value. But most of the time, the modern axe would block 100% of damage, because it will say on the left there, block damage, zero. Now the painted female, that did 34 as well, no variation. And the normal female includes hair and the bald version, that one did 34 as well. So females are actually quite a bit weaker in their damage towards the player. Next is a pale male. Pale male, that sounds funny. Now these are pale ones, are actually a cave ones, I believe. Now these do 36 damage. Some attacks did do 40, though it was quite rare. Which, these are odd because these spawn around day 5, normal spawn on day 1, and the normals actually do more damage than them. Though I didn't go down in the cave and deal with those ones, I just spawned these ones in, so they might be a different variant. Though the amount of time I spent on this video, I'm kind of just done, I can't do any more testing on this. So the next is the normal male. His attacks did 40. Now some attacks did do 32 as well, though quite rare. Now when talking about the normal males and that, this includes the leader version. His behavior is a lot different, but his damage is exactly the same. I'm not sure about his health though. They might be different, though their behavior is definitely different. They try to stay out of the fight. I think the easiest way to identify a normal one is that they've just got normal skin, like the typical brownish, whitish skin, though they can vary a lot in what they wear. They can sometimes be wearing completely different tribal outfits. And as you can see here, these are the normal leader ones. They do the exact same damage, and it's across the board. So the painted leaders do the exact same as well. Babies are next. They do 42 damage, and they can double hit you. So that's scary. You don't want to get double hit. Next is a Virginia. This also does 42 damage. This one can double hit you as well. I think it might be a glitch. I don't think they intended for this to happen. It's where they hit you, and you actually take damage twice. And when you're taking 42 damage per hit, getting an 84 damage hit can be quite deadly. Now, all its attacks do 42. It's jumping one, it's single strike, charge, all 42. This is what I meant early on. The idea is just to not get hit. A lot of enemies do triple attacks like the Armsies and Cannibals. They're probably the worst because that's hitting you three times. It doesn't really make sense and it kind of breaks the immersion a little bit. It's just the way it is. Next is the Girl Mutant. Now this one spawns after you end the game and you pick the ending that allows you to continue playing. This is probably one of the hardest enemies to beat. Though if you've got a flare gun, it just wrecks her big time. Now she has attacks that knock you over, so it's a bit similar to how the Worm and Cowman works. Those do 25 damage as well, and they can't be blocked. Though the spinning attack, it hits you about 4 or 5 times, and at 42 damage, you can imagine how destructive that can be. Though that spinning attack can be blocked, which is quite good to know. Blocking is the main thing here. You want to block as much of these as you can, because the damage they do is insane. It doesn't matter if you're blocking with crap weapons like the katana, you're still going to block a large amount of that damage. So when it says it's got zero block, it's lying. It's got a lot, just nowhere near as much as some of the other weapons. Just remember with this one, if you kill it, a single worm drops. You have to kill that single worm, otherwise it'll keep multiplying until it forms a full worm. Next is the Armsy. His damage is 45, and that includes all of his attacks, like the single strike, triple swing, thunderclap. Though I'm 99.9% sure that wobble attack, it does. It should do 45 damage. The thing is, it hits like 4 or 5 times, so you really don't want to get hit by that. So based on this, his triple swing attack is definitely the most deadly. That thunderclap one where he hits the ground and makes that big boom noise. You'd think that would do a lot more damage, but no, it's only 45. So the Armsy's damage is actually quite low. Though against buildings and stuff, that's where it gets different. He seems to do a lot more damage to buildings. Actually, all these larger mutants, they do a lot more damage to buildings than the normal cannibals. A lot of the cannibals can't actually destroy structures in the game. But it looks like they're destroying them, but they're not. Like the defensive wall. If one was hitting a defensive wall for like 20 hours, it wouldn't destroy it. It would look like it's damaging, but it's not. It's doing like 0.0000 infinity 0.1%. It's like crazy small damage. Next is the gray or blue Virginia. Now this is a rarer variant and spawns later in the game. It double hit me. Now the reason I didn't die is because of the adrenaline rush thing in the game. That's where if you get hit by an attack that would normally kill you, it'll put you down to 1% health. I think you get 50 stamina, you get bonus melee damage, and yeah, you don't die. So it's got a cooldown of 2 minutes. It's a very good feature to have in the game because the amount of damage these enemies can do is insane. You really don't want to get hit. You really don't. So armor is very good. Warm suit is not classed as armor, so don't use that. Next is the skinned and masked cannibal. They did 56, and some of their attacks did 58. These are the late game cannibals. If you get to the late game, 80 to 90% of the enemies you're gonna see. The painted leader and the painted ones actually do the exact same damage. I don't know what the difference is between the painted and skinned ones. Obviously, there's visual difference, though the health on the skinned ones might be higher. I did find that the painted male sometimes did 63 damage, and it was quite common. If you were blocking with the modern axe, when it did 63 damage, it would allow 1 damage through. This is one of the only enemies that can actually damage you when you're blocking with the modern axe. You don't need the turtle shell or rusty axe to block damage. Okay, now we're getting onto the second last, and that is the Grey Armsy. He does 60 damage per hit, and that includes all of his attacks. He's one that you don't want to get hit by. Normal Armsy does 45, this one does 60, so it's about 25% more. Oh, I'm crap with numbers and math. And uploading regular videos. Now the thing that causes the highest damage in the game is the Fireman. Though this would vary if you're on normal mode or not, because his attack does 24 damage, and then if he sets you on fire, that does 80 damage. So technically he does 104 damage if he sets you on fire with that hit. Now his Molotovs that he throws, they only do fire damage, so it hits you and it does 4 ticks of 20 damage. Now this is a lot lower on normal mode. This is only 8 damage at 4 ticks, so it brings it up to 32. And his damage will probably be half, so it'll be 12 damage for the hit and then 32 damage for the fire. That's still a fairly strong hit. That's like 44 damage. Hopefully I got that right, because I'm not going to go back and re-record that if I got it wrong during the editing process. You can block its left hand attacks, but it will set you on fire, causing the 80 damage. Unless you can put yourself out, like if it's raining or you jump into water, etc. His right hand attack doesn't set you on fire, so you gotta work around that. It's alright to get hit by his right hand attack, it doesn't do that much damage, but his left hand attack will damage you and set you on fire. And if you've got that bug that I had in season 5 towards the end where fire damage would do like 400 damage, you're not going to want to be set on fire by this guy. But yeah, his jumping attack uses his right hand, it doesn't set you on fire. So the top damage would probably be disputed between the Grey Armsy and the Fireman. Now, the order I had them in doesn't necessarily mean that they're more deadly, because the Worm has the second lowest damage, but obviously it can be a lot more destructive. I just put them in order of how much damage they did. I can't determine what's easier to beat, because that would be subjective. For example, I find the Armsy a lot easier to kill than the Virginia. You might find the Virginia easier to kill over the Armsy. And the Girl Mutant, for example, is about halfway on this list. And if you don't have a flare gun, she can be really difficult to kill. Her hitbox is a complete mess. Hitting her with arrows is near impossible. Though if you're using fire arrows, yeah, you might be doing alright. Anyway, that's all the damage they do. Like I said, I'll put something in the video to show the damage on normal compared to hard and hard survival. So yeah, the difference between hard and hard survival is the survival features. I'll put a link to the information on the wiki. I've been trying to clean it up to make it easy to understand, though it's been very difficult to do. Now here's a bonus that I thought I'd test while I was here, because it shows you how much damage you take. On hard survival, when you're drowning, you take 10 damage per second. So it would only take 10 seconds underwater if you had full health to kill you. Sorry my uploads haven't been as frequent. I've been meaning to address it in a separate video though. I don't know how to word it, but there's a fairly decent reason for it. Though, it's not going to be a permanent thing. I will be uploading more frequently, probably shortly, I'd say. Anyway, if you like this video, make sure you like and subscribe. Cheers.